With SnapGene, you can create and annotate sequences, design primers, and plan, simulate, and validate cloning experiments. SnapGene can also align DNA or RNA sequences and simulate agarose gel electrophoresis. Let's demonstrate. You can define a folder as a project to manage and work with your files directly within SnapGene. Let's import a raw vector sequence into SnapGene. Paste the sequence into the new sequence window, and SnapGene will automatically annotate the sequence using a curated library of common plasmid features. And just like that, we've created an annotated plasmid displayed as a tab in the main SnapGene window. Save the new sequence to your project folder. This map view can be changed using the left toolbar. For example, we can show or hide restriction enzyme sites, find predicted open reading frames, and change how features are displayed. To view the sequence, switch to the sequence view. Here you can also control the view using the left toolbar or type directly in the sequence view to edit. SnapGene will automatically translate coding sequence features. If no stop codon is present, the translation will continue until the next stop codon. This makes it easy to spot errors and understand in-frame fusions. This new sequence was annotated using SnapGene's built-in library of common plasmid features. However, you can also save your own custom features and then detect them on your new sequences. You can easily choose what enzymes to display on a sequence and save custom enzyme sets. There is also the ability to simulate agarose gels in SnapGene. Assign different sequences to different lanes and choose different combinations of restriction enzymes. SnapGene makes it easy to work with primers too. If you have existing primers, store these in a delimited list and import matching primers onto your sequences. You can view the primers on the sequence and as a list in the primers view. It's also possible to manually create your own primers. Just highlight a region of the sequence, confirm the TM, and add the primer. You can also add extensions to the primers, such as restriction sites or nucleotides. SnapGene will automatically design appropriate primers for PCR in cloning experiments and assist with creating complex assemblies using one or many inserts. SnapGene can simulate PCR, restriction cloning, Gibson assembly, infusion cloning, NB Hi-Fi assembly, Golden Gate assembly, and Gateway assembly. Let's demonstrate and simulate Gibson assembly with one insert. Open the Gibson assembly cloning tool, choose the vector, and define the region for assembly. Then select the insert sequence and define the region for assembly. In the product tab, have SnapGene design the primers required to create overlaps. Click Assemble, and that's it. We have our predicted Gibson assembly construct. We can turn on the history coloring to see the assembled fragments. In history view, we can see the steps we have simulated. The new primers are annotated on the sequence, and a list of primers is in the primers view. From here, we can export the primers and order them. So now we have our virtual construct. It's back to the lab to do this for real. Finally, you can use SnapGene to validate your clones by aligning Sanger reads to the predicted product sequence. SnapGene automatically trims low-quality regions and aligns the reads. It will automatically highlight disagreements so you can quickly jump to them. View the underlying trace and edit it if needed. You can also view the effect of differences on CDS translations. And all this work we've demonstrated is neatly contained in a single file. You can hide the alignment and return to the sequence view we had earlier. Or we can jump back to the map view. The description panel allows you to add notes and other information. And that's a short demonstration of how SnapGene can improve your core molecular biology procedures and results. Visit snapgene.com to sign up for your 30-day free trial.